Hello friends, welcome to the channel, The Nurse. Here we are discusses common sample collection bottles and vacutainers. The contents are culture bottles, sterile cotton swabs and urine bottle, sterile container, sodium citrate or blue top vacutainer, red top or plain vacutainer, EDTA or purple top vacutainer, yellow or gold top vacutainer, black top or ESR vacutainer, grey top or grey top vacutainer. And first, culture bottle. Here are three culture bottles. First is pediatric culture bottle, and second one is adult culture bottle. That is red top, and third one is adult aerobic culture bottle. Once again, first one is pediatric culture bottle, second one is adult anaerobic culture bottle, and third one is adult aerobic culture bottle. This is BD Bactec company adult aerobic culture bottle. In this 8 to 10 ml is required. There is a culture media for bacterial growth. This is purple bottle. And this is Bactelite company adult aerobic culture bottle. This is green top. But purpose is same. The culture media is different according to company. So these are the bottles. Left one is BD Bactec company adult aerobic culture bottle, and right side is Bactelite company aerobic culture bottle. See that culture media, that is different. So media inside the bottle will be favorable to microbial growth, but may different according to making company. Example, Bactelite culture media is adsorbent polymeric beads, but it is different in BD Bactec company aerobic culture bottle. Blood volume required. Ideally, two different samples are required, but it may vary according to institutional policy. For adult patient, 3 to 10 ml is required, and for pediatric patient, 1 to 3 ml. After collecting blood sample in bottle, gently invert the bottle 6 times to mix with the medium. Next, sterile cotton swab. This is sterile cotton swab inside a plastic cover, and the cotton swab contains sterile container. Okay. So, we can remove the cotton swab and take the sample, and we can close it. It should be a sterile procedure. This is sterile cotton swab with sterile container for easy carrying. Swab can be taken from all sides. Before taking swab from any wound, it should be thoroughly cleaned with the saline and should not use antiseptic solution for cleaning. Next is, this is urine sample collection bottle. It may be sterile or clean bottle. For culture, urine culture and urine routine examination, sterile bottle is required. For urine electrolytes, osmolality and ketones test, clean container is enough. So, it is used for collect urine sample, for urine routine examination, urine osmolality and electrolytes, urine ketone identification. For urine culture test, a sterile sample bottle is required. Stool samples also can collect with the spatula. A special stool container with the spatula is not available. This is also sterile container, wide mouth sterile container. This is a universal one. It's written as sterile. It is a universal sterile container. It is also used to collect urine for culture and sensitivity and other urine tests. It can also be used to collect all types of sterile body fluids, body tissues for histopathology tests. Next is sodium citrate or blue top vacutainer. In this additive is this, that is sodium citrate, the marked level, blood should filled up to the marked level and invert the bottles 6 times to mix the sample. So additive is sodium citrate, cap color is blue. It must be filled up to the marked level. Used for coagulation studies, that is prothrombin time, activated partial thromboplastin time or APTT and INR, international normalized ratio. And to get the fibrinogen level, also it's used to test D-dimer. The value is raised in DVT and pulmonary embolism. Next is red top or plain vacutainer. In this, a clot activator will be there. This is used to test serum samples. So, additive is clot activator and cap color is red. Blood volume required is 6 ml maximum according to the number of tests. Used mainly for biochemistry and drug levels and serological test that require serum. And also used for group and cross matching, immunohematological studies. Next, EDTA or purple vacutainer. Additive is dipotassium ethylene dioxide tetraacetate. Top color is purple and blood volume is required 3 ml up to the marked level. It is mainly used for hematological studies, include hemoglobin, total WBC count, platelet count or complete blood count. And it is also used to test HbA1c, that is used in diabetic and hemocysteine study, cyclosporine and molecular genetic studies. These are the main use of EDT or purple vacutainer. Next is yellow or gold top vacutainer. This is also used for serum studies. And in this, a clot activator and a gel separator is there. So, during centrifugation, that gel separator will separate serum and blood cells. Additive is SST2 clot activator and gel serum separator. Cap color yellow. Sometimes it's known as gold top. And blood volume required 5 ml maximum according to the number of tests. Used for all tests requiring serum except those few that need red cells as well. And that's include serum electrolytes, liver function test, renal function test, thyroid function test, serum calcium, serum phosphorus and cardiac enzymes like TROP-T and C-reactive protein, etc. Next is black top or ESR vacutainer. This is also a sodium citrate bottle and it is have a mark, and in glass ESR bottle it's required 3.8% of sodium citrate and plastic bottle it's required 3.2% of sodium citrate. Additive is 3.8% sodium citrate in glass bottle and 3.2% sodium citrate in plastic tube. Top color is black and used for erythrocyte sedimentation rate or ESR test. Next is gray top. In gray top, additive used is sodium fluoride or potassium oxalate. Top color is gray. Blood volume required 6 ml maximum. And it is mainly used for glucose test, that is fasting blood sugar, random blood sugar, or glucose tolerance test. The main benefit is the additive in this tube prevents glycolysis of blood and gives accurate report. Then, after collecting blood sample, how to invert the vacutainer? Just gently invert the bottles. Usually, it's required 3 to 6 times. This is gentle method of inverting the vacutainer, and important thing is do not shake vigorously. It causes hemolysis. Gentle invert the vacutainer 3 to 6 times for mixing the blood with additives. And one more important thing is do not fill too less or too large quantity into the vacutainers. Thank you. Please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe this channel, The Nurse. Thank you.